Please hit the subscribe button and tap the bell icon for the future notification to watch more videos of latest fashions and trends. Thank you so much for your love and support. Hello friends, welcome back to Amazing Women's World. This is in continuation with the previous video. I've shown the drafting and cutting an empire line A-line top cutting. Please do watch with the link appearing in front of your screen. Also, the details available in the description box if you haven't watched it. I've separated this top part of the fabric and trimmed according to the measurements I've shown. The yoke pattern, now I'd be cutting the bottom, which is A-line pattern. Total length of the bottom part which I'm taking is of 26 inches. This includes with the seam allowance. And this fabric I have given 2 folds into 4 layers. On the top here, I'd be marking the bust line measurements which I took 7.5 inches. Also marking 1.5 inches for the seam allowance. And for the total flare, this is on 4 panels. I'd be using the complete width of the fabric to give the full flare to this A-line top. So the total width I'd be taking, which is of 20 inches here. Now I'll join these two lines with the slanting line. Now I'll cut on the marked lines. According to the print, I have selected the A-line pattern. But if you are going with the plain fabric, you can also use the circle pattern or the anarkali pattern. Use the complete fabric width wise to get the complete flare. It's a loose type garment from the bust line. Let's start the stitching with the concealing of the sleeve opens. I'll be placing the border underneath, wrong side of the sleeve and the right side of the border. And start stitching. Now turn the border to the right side of the sleeve and give the top stitch. Fold 1/4 inch in on the top side and give the top stitch. The same way conceal another side sleeve too, like how I have shown now. This is how the sleeve would look. Now I'll join the interfacing neckline. Place both right sides together and start joining, giving the stitch. Double fold the interfacing neckline and give the top stitch. Now I'll conceal the raw edge of this slit. Placing this strip, I have concealed this strip also. Place both right sides together and give the stitch in the shape of V. I'm done with the stitching. Now I'll give the slit till this end. Now I'll join the interfacing necklines. Before that, flip this strip towards the wrong side and give the top stitch. Fold the strip edges and give the top stitch. Now I lay the interfacing necklines. I've also sewed here, just folded a little in and given the stitch. Now I'll lay both right sides together and join both the necklines. Now fold the strip towards another side and give the top stitch. Again completely turn towards wrong side and give the stitch joining with the neckline. This way you'll get the nicer finishings on the neckline. You can see here, this is how the front and back panels would look. And the concealed sleeve opens with the borders. Now I'll join the shoulder line, placing both right sides together and join the shoulders. Joining the sleeves with the armhole of the bodies, laying both right sides together, start sewing. If you're done with the cutting perfectly, you'll get the perfect joining of the armhole without wrinkles, and this is how it looks. Now I'll join the bottom of the A-line with the bust line of this bodies, placing both right sides together. Join on this bust line both panels of the A-line with the empire line bodies. Now I'll give the stitch. Flip the seam elements towards the empire line bodies and give the top stitch. Now I'll join the sides, starting with the sleeves. You can see here the marked line, I'm stitching on that line. Conceal the hemline raw edges, giving the double fold, give the stitch. I'd also decorate the top with the tassels. For this, I'd be using this yarn. Using the strip of 1.5 inches, wrap it around 15 rounds. Tie on one end. Inserting the gold bead here, cut on another end. Now I'll join this to the sleeves and also the hemline. Secure it by giving the tight knot. This way I'll join the tassels on the sleeves and the hemline of this beautiful empire line kurti to give the gorgeous look. The final lookout of empire line top is here. Give it a try, pair it with jeans or leggings or just like that, like a dress. You'll definitely receive an appreciation for your adorable dress you wore. So friends, what were you waiting? Try it and share your wonderful experience through comments. Having any doubts, do write to me and also share your feedback on this pattern. Thank you so much for watching friends. Meet you all with another interesting video. Subscribe and stay tuned to watch more videos of latest fashions and trends.